guys, welcome back to my channel. How y'all doing? So, how about this update? I got a story time too. But Bow Wow, the young lady, I was, you know, go back. I always go back and look at the news and catch up on whatever I reported on. Police report says that the young lady says that her and Bow Wow was out or getting ready to go out. She was dancing with another man named Shaquille. It's not confirmed. As of me making this video, I didn't see it confirmed whether it was Shaquille O'Neal. Nonetheless, she was hanging all over the guy. Bow Wow supposedly got jealous. It went from a shouting match to a physical match. Supposedly, he grabbed her by her hair and drug her through the house, their apartment, in every room. And then she got the lamp and all of this other stuff. Listen here. Listen here. Bow Wow, if you did that, you had every lick you got. Every lick you got. You needed it and you deserved it. Okay? So, it still doesn't negate from keep your hands to yourself. We got to learn that when we get in arguments, tempers are going to fly. They're going to do what they're going to do, but you still don't have a right to touch nobody. Okay, and I still meant to bring awareness and attention to, at the end of the day, men do get abused. Men are not always the aggressor. Men do get sexually assaulted. Men don't want to be sexually assaulted. It's not cute. So I'm not taking away from anything I said in the last video. It's just that I'm updating what I've read. And if, in fact, he was the aggressor, then he deserved everything that he got plus some. Okay, so wanted to get on that, but let's get to story time. I hadn't talked about, I've done a story in a minute. So how about, because she's dead, I'm not going to say her name or anything, but this was, oh God, my baby wasn't even born, my 9-year-old. So this was well over 16, let's say 16 years ago. No, because that baby, my 6-year-old baby, she knew her. So we're going to say 14. Let's go with 14. So 14 years ago. I'm sorry. So 14 years ago, I was at work, met a young lady. She was really nice. She was sweet. She had a little girl. She was a single mom. We were vibing, just going through that transition of no good man in our life at the time. You know, we were like the He-Man. Who was it in the Little Rascals? The He-Man Woman Haters Club. We was the She-Ra Man Haters Club. You know, it was just, she was really cool. She was great to be around. She was fun. Her little girl and my daughter played well. It was great. We ended up getting a job at the same company. It was a little factory job we had. We worked hard. And for all intents and purposes, this was a wonderful, wonderful woman. My heart went out to her. She appeared very trustworthy. She did nothing to make me believe that she was not trustworthy. Nothing at all. Well, she met a guy and she started dating him. Now, right before she met him, I want to say a good 4 months after we became friends, she got put out of her house, okay? Her and the boyfriend fell out. I didn't question. Because my thing is, you got a baby. Well, she wasn't a baby, but she's a toddler. You got a toddler. He's throwing you out. Come on, you're my best friend. Come on to my house, her and her baby. So she came to my house. As a matter of fact, I went and picked her up. It was rough. Excuse me. A little burp came out. My apologies. Picked her up, and she basically, of course, he was trying to fight me, blah, 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 called me worthless, this, that, and the third. I made you, do, 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 do. So she comes, and she never goes back to him. There was never any drama at my house about it, anything. She left him all the way alone. He was not the father of that child that she had with her. Fast forward, she meets a guy at work. He is an epileptic. He had seizures really bad. But he was still able to hold a job. He just could not drive at all. No license, denied it, and everything. So she got to know him. They got the vibing and everything. Everything was going well. So I would see her a little less and less. And I get it. You get in a relationship, you got to spend time with your man. But I'm a big believer in, just because I get in a relationship or if I get married, I'm not losing focus on my girls that's been there ride or dies. I'm not getting rid of them. Now, will the relationship, I don't want to use the word slow down, but married and relationship do require you to spend time with your boo. But we're not going to stop calling. We're not going to fall off like that. So she started spending a little less time, and it was no biggie. You've grown. Go live your life. I said they'll probably be moving in together sometime soon. No biggie. I get a call this particular night. She spends the night out. She's like, I'm going over to his house. I may or may not be back. And I was like, okay, well, just let me know that you made it in safe. So she has her daughter with her. She took her daughter everywhere. I don't see her at work the next morning. I'm like, she had never missed work. I'm like, okay. I text her. And of course you text the traditional best friend stuff. Bitch, where's you at? Get up off the dick. That always, whenever I text her something crazy or she texts me, it was just a response. She didn't respond back. I'm like, okay, but I got to focus at work. Got to keep my money up. I can't be worried about her. I'm like, this something new? Do you? I'm working. So get off work. The girl didn't show up. No call back. Call the phone. It's just ringing. So I go home. I got a call from a man. He was like, hi, is this Keva? I'm like, this is Keva. Hey. He was like, I'm friends. No, I'm the ex-husband of such and such, the young lady. He said, and I just wanted to let you know that she was killed last night. I was like, she was killed? He was like, apparently she let her boyfriend drive and he had a seizure while driving and he flew into the other lane, hit a tree, crashed the car into a tree. I was so stunned because my thing was, she knew he couldn't drive. She knew he had seizures. But she's passed on. They both were killed. They both were killed. I called my coworkers who was close to her, like me, another good friend, because she had got cool with a lot of us. And her funeral was, Indiana or Illinois. It was a little drive, not that far. A little drive. We drove there. And the whole way there, we're all shocked. Like, she let him drive? Like, really? We went to go see the car. You know, where her car was. Because her husband was like, can you get some of her personal things out of the car and bring them with you? I'm like, yeah, I'll salvage whatever I can. The engine was in the front seat. The windshield was a horror story. It was exactly the way I never wanted to picture. I could only imagine. My heart just was breaking. So I grabbed whatever I could grab. I don't really quite remember. It's been a minute. We get to the funeral. So,
I'm sorry.
Excuse me. So, I've never met the husband. Let me tell you, didn't know the ex-husband existed. Didn't know he existed. So, okay. Go in there. I'm not knowing who to look for. I'm like, hey, I'm here for such and such funeral. I'm Keva. She lived with me. And they was like, oh, such and such. So here come the husband. He was like, how you doing? I'm at a loss right here. He said, well, this is her daughter. Now, the little girl that was with her, that's who I knew was her daughter. But here before me was another girl who was about 12. And she had the little girl with her was 6, maybe? This girl was 12. And I was like, her daughter's like, hi. And she was just so upset, just crying. She's like, hi. She was like, yes, Ramona had three. I said her name. The young lady had three kids. I was like, three kids? I said, I have to apologize. I only knew about the little one. She said she only had one child. And he was like, that's what she does. I'm like, that's what she does. He was like, he said, unfortunate under these circumstances, you're, you know, going to find out some things you didn't really want to find out. He said, but she has three kids. He said, and she's a habitual liar. She was not liked by a lot of people. And I was just, you're talking about mouth hung open, like, but I loved her. She was awesome. She was my girl. So I give him our stuff. I go to my car, give her stuff, go up there and see her in a casket. And you could tell she was damaged. They had a veil over, it was a soft light bulb in there, and they had a veil covering her. Because they said her face kept sliding. It was just so sad. And looking at her, I'm like, that's my friend. He said she's a liar and a horrible person and nobody liked her. That's my girl right there. I was so heartbroken. I was so confused. So we take a seat and some police officers come, sheriffs. Comes this young lady in a, I don't want to say orange jumpsuit. That's so cliche, like I'm making it up, like in a movie. But I want to say it was,
okay.
I know you like, bitch, stop getting on here yarning. It's the ring light. Because I wasn't that sleepy when I sat down. I'm sorry. It was a jumpsuit though. Whether it was orange, blue, I can't remember. But orange is sticking to me. But that's because I just saw something on TV with a prisoner in orange jumpsuit. So I don't want to, like, I'm lying. So I don't remember the jumpsuit. But she was shackled. Her wrist was shackled to her waist, ankles, and feet. Child, that was her daughter. I said her daughter. And he was like, mm-hmm. He said her daughter that she totally don't deal with. The young lady was 16. She gets up there and she gives the most heartbreaking speech. Basically, mama, why you didn't want me? Mama, I loved you. You never wrote me. I love you, mama. You never loved me. Just, I was so, so floored. The other daughter was sitting next to the little one that I knew. And of course, you know, when I hugged the little one, she was like, you know, she knew me. She hugged me. The other little girl said, I'm so sorry that I don't know you, sweetie, but she looked just like her mom too. I'm like, you look just like your mom. I'm so sorry. And she hugged me and she was just broke down. And I'm like, this lady had three kids, three children, and said she was the mother to one. So it was so much to process at this funeral. There had to be 50 people there.
This a whole, honey.
This a whole mess with this yarning. This a whole mess. I'm sorry. Oh my God. I can't. That's a whole mess with this yarning. And I'm not that sleepy, y'all. I was just so outdone that I actually, let me give you my quotes, knew her, moved her into my home, called her one of my best friends. She was awesome. She was cool. She was good people. And they said she was basically a demon, that she stole identities, was probably going to steal mine. I said, steal mine? Honey, she would have stole mine and been locked up with mess around with my credit. Don't do that. Mm-mm. But she was a very bad person. And I was none the wiser. So that story time is to say, a sheep in wolf's clothing, beware. If you believe in church, if you believe in God, there's a scripture in Revelations that said that the devil was one of God's most beautiful angels. The devil does not show up all the time dressed as this ugly, atrocious moment in your life or entity. I'm messing up the word. The devil will come to you as everything you need at the moment you think you need it. When I met her, I was just out of a relationship. I was heartbroken. She was going through a bad relationship. She was heartbroken. It was relatable. She was a single mom for all intents and purposes. She had one child. We bonded. The devil came to me as what I needed. And I was his prey. I was going to be his prey. I was going to be preyed upon. I just don't know how she was going to do it. I hate to think of her as a person that I couldn't trust, that I didn't know, but I literally didn't know the young lady because everyone there that was talking to me was like, oh yeah, we heard about you. We were just hoping we could get to you in time, but you shouldn't let her in your house. I'm like, but I got to know her. I got to know her. She was my friend. I trusted her. And she was not my friend. And I could not trust her. So with that being said, people, everything that glitters isn't gold. A man, a woman, a friendship, all of it. Pay close attention to it. Listen more than you speak, I hope that never happens to me again, as far as a person being basically she was a stranger. Like, really? You had 3 kids. And your ex-husband and other people there said, nobody liked you. That was so deep to me. And when I tell you, my memories were fond. And she was not liked. No, ma'am. Yeah, so that's my story time, guys. I just wanted to talk about me meeting someone that I thought was who they were and they were not. And put in the comments, have you met somebody that you didn't know that was completely opposite of what they presented themselves to be? Because I feel stupid behind that. Like, how did... Girl, my daughter be doing her own little thing. So, catch y'all up on this hair. What I did was I randomly grabbed hair, retwisted it, took it loose because it has not been done, thoroughly done. I'm supposed to roller set it. And I just kind of reparted it here and pulled the hair over and then just fluffed it up and made it bigger. I am very lazy when it comes to natural hair. I don't make effort, except when I roll a set, because it takes time. I'm going to be doing some reviews on natural hair products and stuff like that in the future. But yeah, I'm team natural, and I'm trying to, incorporate that in some of my videos. But Comment below if you met someone that was not what they said. Like, she was, they and the family were, they were, when I say this was her family, like, oh no, we don't, like, we only having this funeral because she had insurance, or they would just, you know, they, this just family and her daughters. It was really crazy. It was really crazy. That was a crazy moment in my life. And she did. And the day before she got killed, though, we were singing, it was a T-Pain song, and that was something about shaking, breaking, thinking, trying to get to you and that monkey, trying to get to you and that monkey. I know I got judged like that, but that was the little song. It was the only part I can remember. And she used to do this little dance with her daughter. That was the day before she got killed, like when she left. Like, that's the last memory I got of her. Every time I hear that song, even my kid, my daughter that knew her. Remember Ramona? I said her name. But you know what? I said her name. I'm not deleting this video. It is what it is. It's not a lie. You know, it's not a lie. I didn't really prefer to say her name, but I said damn child, damn girl's name twice. But yeah. So, that's it for me, guys. Y'all have a good one. Thank you for stopping by. Again, if you made it to the end of this video, I appreciate you. Thank you. Hit the like, subscribe, leave a comment, and come back and see me. All right. Have a good one.